top of the Mitchell. This 17 games came into this one with a little bit of turbulence. Difference of opinion if he could play game one. Move down again. There he goes down. And this is why they're careful with him, and they were overly cautious. They felt in game one by not playing him, even though he wanted to do badly. It's a rugged game, Reg, and these are the playoffs, and there is no shying from contact.
This is going to be a long series as well.
Trying to wrangle him in is going to be a huge chore. We're going to bring him out. Quinn has seen enough. Last year, Reggie, Utah had a 3-1 lead. Lost it in the bubble, even though this guy averaged over 36 a game in those playoffs. And they had to deal with that going into this season. There was some mental rearranging they had to do. They've all acknowledged it. It was not an easy get back together, guys. Here we go. About 2 months after that all happened, and Quinn had his hands full, as he has admitted. And it took a while for them to kind of gain their paces and shake that off and begin anew.
Well, they're going to be dealing with it in this series. They already lost home court advantage, right? So they've got to go on the road. And again, they've had the best record in the league this season. So you know they can go into any place and win.
Monday they play game four, Saturday on ESPN game three. Fun series though, with England bringing it by midcourt. Memphis was down by 22 and came to within 2 points. Anderson got it. The Allen Juniors will finish off at 18. Donovich at 18 points, 29 in game one in that losing cause for Utah. 11 O'Neal, 21 Gobert, 13 boards. Mitchell at 25 on the bench and finished. Royce O'Neal. Pretty shot. He's got 14, Rich.
19 made threes for the Jazz. 19.
Brooks putting up a fadeaway and O'Neal to grab it. Stay tuned for Inside the NBA. Our guys are ready. And waiting to take over the reins of this broadcast and talk about the night in the NBA. The Knicks with a terrific win. Randall was wonderful. That series is tied at one. This series will be tied at one. A lot to talk about with Lakers-Phoenix tomorrow night on TNT. And the Lakers, I thought Reggie began to look like the Lakers as that game was winding down last night. Here's Morant with the three. It's picked up by Valanciunas, and Brooks will put up the three, and he'll drain it from outside.
70 points between combined Ja Morant and Dylan Brooks.
Nice looking win tonight for the Utah Jazz. The number one seed is just tied this series at 1 apiece.